To sum it up, there were three main responsibilities that were given to the tribesmen. Number one, to protect the roads so that the military supplies are safe and secure. Don't give shelter to the state offenders. And thirdly, don't allow your territory to be a launching pad for any expedition or any army operation on the British Empire. In response, the government will pay allowances to the tribe. The allowances were in three kinds. First, cash allowances to the whole tribe, known as Mawajib. Secondly, to the chiefs, to the Maliks, in terms of Maliki and Lungi. And thirdly, recruitment of their young people as Khasadars and Levy Sipais, to have a local force and to make it sure that the government interests are protected by the tribal chiefs with the help of the local levies and Khasadars. That not only provided a job and employment opportunity for the local youth, but also disassociated them from any unlawful activity. We will speak about later on. When we just went and opened the area through a road, all these negotiations, these treaties, these agreements, they were taken in haste, and that social compatibility could not be reached. This I am talking as a history to you. Now there is a Durand line. Durand line has a significance in the policy making for tribesmen, for FATA. First, Durand line is not a geographical boundary that it separates two different areas, nor it is an ethnic boundary that it separates two different nations, two different ethnic groups. It is known as a scientific border or a strategic boundary border. The only reason that this border was fixed, that the British government wanted to assure that all the strategic routes, all the strategic passes are within the limits of the British Empire. So all the routes, Khyber Pass, Gomal Pass, Nawa Pass, Tochi Pass, every pass was in the limits of the tribal area. And as soon as the passes ended, then the Durand line, the other side of the Durand line, Afghan territory started. This has resulted now in many problems. For example, there you will find many tribes who are living on both sides of the boundary. And I will give you a very interesting example of South Waziristan, where there is a Tujikhel tribe. Tujikhel tribe is a Wazir tribe. It lives on the other side of the boundary, but it has a grazing right in area close to Karak, which is in the settled districts of Khyber Pakhtunkhwa province. And then the British government also extended the easement rights to these tribesmen, that they could cross the boundary without document, without passport, without visa. So now, when in 2010 somebody wants to close the border, to most of the people who do not know the exact situation on the ground, to them it is like closing the door of the house or closing the door of the drawing room, which is not the case. It is creating a little problem for me, but yes. Some of the characteristics of this area. Number one, it's hilly. Pine, oak, forest, perfect for guerrilla war. Weather unfriendly. You will find on one hand snow peaks, freezing temperatures in Koh-e Safed, the opposite side of Tora Bora, and on the other hand, sizzling temperatures in Jandola and FRDI Khan that made the tribesmen hardy and resistant to all such changes that weather can bring. And the most important point is that there is small land holdings, very little irrigation water, so it is not sustainable. FATA is not a sustainable area. A very recent survey that we conducted through our international partners, UNDP, UNICEF, it shows 43% of population, 43% living outside FATA to earn their livelihood. If you also take into consideration that one man earns and the entire family spends, then this percentage speaks about some very poor living conditions in the area. That almost every family is dependent upon remittances or jobs outside the tribal area. And this area has always been a food deficient area, always been a food deficient area. There is a small anecdote that there was a problem of food in Afghanistan during King Zahir Shah days, and they were planning how to cope with it. When it came to the border area, they said, forget about it. Pakistan will take care of it. Because the food deficiency then results in taking food supplies from Pakistan and then onward smuggling to Afghanistan. It becomes a business for them. Now, these are some of the statistics. And they are very important to note. Cultivated area and irrigated areas. The long history of underdevelopment has also resulted in the low production. You can see the wheat yield of FATA as compared to Pakistan, and also the maize yield, the two staple crops there. Coming down to the next slide, you can see some more social indicators. I think the most important one is, if you look at the population per irrigated hectare, it is 44 in tribal area as compared to 9 in rest of Pakistan. And then the female literacy, 3%. And the literacy is defined just somebody who can read a line in any language. So in a society where female are just 3%, when we are talking of giving rights to the female by sending their representative to the legislative assemblies or to the higher judiciary, it means we have also something missed in the root cause of the non-participation of women in the national affairs. And that is how to bring their life to the normal citizen, at least to that standard.